थैंक यू। हेलो, आई एम ऑडिबल? यस, सो थैंक यू भाग्य। प्रोग्राम्स लाइक दिस डू नॉट सिंपली हैपन ओवरनाइट। द प्रिपरेशन हैज बीन गोइंग ऑन सिंस लास्ट बज़र्का, एंड आई एम प्राउड टू से दैट दिस इज द ब्रेन चाइल्ड ऑफ अ पर्सन with lots of enthusiasm and passion for research. I'm glad to invite Dr. Bhagya Devarajan, Assistant Professor, Department of Home Science and Research Committee Coordinator, to welcome this virtual gathering.
Thank you. Over to you. Thank you, Ms. Nisha. Thank you so much. So a warm good evening to one and all. I consider it as a great privilege to welcome all the dignitaries and delegates who have witnessed Research 2021 as a memorable and successful event fostering research culture among the stakeholders. The research journey started from October 5th and culminated to a fruitful end by October 11th, 2021, covering 10 plenary talks and 120 oral presentations in UGPG research scholar and faculty category from multidisciplines. At the outset, I warmly welcome you all wholeheartedly to the valedictory function of Research National Conference 2021. I would like to welcome our beloved manager, Reverend Dr. Sister Annie Matthew, a strong support for all our endeavors and for being with us today. I wholeheartedly welcome our respected principal, Dr. Rita Letha Dikoto, for being the catalyst that stimulated us to do our best and standing as a pillar of strength. We welcome you, Miss.
Thank you.
We are privileged to have Dr. Gabriel Simon Patil, a professor and head, Department of Commerce, University of Kerala, as our chief guest for his gracious presence. Dr. Gabriel Simon Patil is the person behind keeping the accountability and transparency in quality management system of University of Kerala as our IQAC director. On behalf of IQAC and research committee of St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha, we welcome you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I also welcome all the dignitaries who accompanied with us in the Knowledge Fiesta, especially Dr. G. Gopakumar, former Vice Chancellor, Central University of Kerala, Kasaragod, who gracefully inaugurated our Research 2021 event. I wholeheartedly welcome Professor Dr. Idathil Vijayan, President of Society of Biotechnologists India, Dr. T. Pradeep, Chairman, Alappuzha District Subcommittee for Education, Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad, Mr. Raju Palliparambil, our PTA Vice President, and all members of collaboration to this event. With utmost respect, I wholeheartedly welcome all our subject experts and National Advisory Committee members who supported and enlightened us in all possible manner. We feel proud and happy with your presence. I welcome Dr. Anju M. Neelera, our IQAC coordinator, who is a constant source of motivation and encouragement to us. I also
thank you, Bhagya.
Thank you, Miss. I also welcome all my colleagues, department coordinators who have spared this precious time in organizing this program. I would also like to welcome the technical staff who work behind the scene to make this event happen, Mr. Akhil and Akshara Koichara. Last but not the least, I welcome all students, research scholars and their supervising guides for showing their interest in this program and giving us immediate feedback. Wish you all the best. Once again, on behalf of IQAC and Research Committee of St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha, I wholeheartedly welcome you all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, dear Dr. Bhagya. Gentle yet strong, confident in her ways and unique in her personality, the head of our institution, our dear principal, Dr. Rita Letha Dikoto, I happily welcome you, dear ma'am, for the presidential address.
Thank you, Nimisha. Our esteemed chief guest of the day, Dr. Gabriel Simon Patil, the head of the Department of Commerce of the University of Kerala, and the Director of the Internal Quality Assurance Cell of the University of Kerala. Our IQAC Coordinator, Dr. Anju, Researcher Coordinator, Dr. Bhagya, our collaborators of this event, Dr. Idathil Vijayan and T. Pradeep, faculty, delegates, and my dear students, and all the members of the research committee too. A very warm good afternoon to all of you. So today is a really special day for us for more reasons than one. One is that this is a second edition of Researcha, an event which met with the overwhelming response when we started this journey last year. I remember that as we were grappling with the challenges presented by the COVID pandemic, our research committee got into proactive mode, headed by the very dynamic coordinator, Dr. Bhagya, and started brainstorming what we could do in these COVID days to get to build capacity in research, which definitely was a need of the hour, because we know our definitions of teaching, learning are slowly changing, whereas earlier education was all about just getting information from the pages of textbooks. Today it has come to mean the art of assisting discovery. It has come to mean doing research which is relevant and which is of quality, research in collaborative teams and in interdisciplinary teams too. So this event was started with the objective of motivating students, research scholars, and faculty to empower themselves and also to do meaningful research. And it started in a small way last year, I think, with the inaugural session was by an inspiring researcher, Dr. Chachankar Nair of the Department of Bioinformatics, where he gave a very, very really inspiring talk, a motivational talk on how we could break away from certain stereotypes of research and do research that is meaningful. So the response to last year's Researcha really prompted us to go into the second edition, which was a little more challenging because we know that not much was happening during the last year in many educational institutions. Yet we got a very, very warm response, we should say, to this initiative. And as Nimisha and Bhagya have already pointed out, more than 120 presentations. And I think the competitions were done in four categories for the UG students, the PG students, for research scholars, and for the faculty. And we had a number of talks. Experts in their own area, and for all those who attended, for all those who were a part of this program, which started this year, it started on October 5th, and today we are bringing the curtain down on this event. And I must just to say a word about the theme. So we know that today, improving research quality, research capability, and also providing an environment which supports researchers, whether they're students, whether they're teachers, providing that environment which both empowers them and which motivates them is definitely a very important, definitely a need in every institution. Earlier, there was this feeling, I think we were all prey to it, that research was for the university departments and teaching was for the affiliated colleges. And we kind of escaped a little from behind that assumption. But nowadays we know that with the different changes coming up in the academic environment, the different requirements for the promotion of teaching faculty, and also the need to make a student grounded in research capabilities from the time students. All these need for promoting a rich culture in our institutions. And that is where this program, Research Cup, becomes so very relevant and meaningful. So I would like to congratulate each and everyone who has been a part of this team, especially the coordinator, Dr. Bhagya, and all the members of the committee, our IQAC coordinator, Dr. Anju, and everyone who worked behind this event. I must also say, when I said that today is special for more reasons than one, I meant it's really very special because we have with us today on this online platform a person whose very name spells excellence, quality for each and every, I think anyone in the University of Kerala has heard of Dr. Gabriel Simon Tuttle. And he is such a very inspirational person. Words fail me when I talk to say, I think my acquaintance with him is for more than two decades. And I have always been so inspired by the kind of person he is, the dedication and commitment that he brings to his role, whatever he does, whether as a teacher or as a research guide or as the head of the Department of Commerce or as a director of the Internal Quality Assurance Cell. He sets a new standard, a new benchmark, whichever role he plays. He dons many hats and he wears them very well indeed. And he is such a motivation to any researcher, be it a student researcher or a teacher or anyone in research. I think just knowing him and interacting with him is a very great inspiration. So yesterday I had to meet him in a professional capacity at the University of Kerala in his department. And I was so struck by the fact that in spite of his very hectic schedule, the pain he took to motivate each and every young researcher who came his way in connection with the registration for the PhD research. The kind of concern, the kind of commitment he shows towards academics and research is definitely unequaled. And I would say that we are so honored, dear sir, to have you with us. I know it would have been very difficult for you to spare your time today, because I think from beginning of the day to the end of the day, his day is packed with meetings, one after the other. And I think it is his commitment to research and his commitment to building capacity in our young students, which has prompted him to take some time off his very, very hectic schedule to be with us today. And I must thank you for being such a very motivating person, for being an exemplar of professional ethics and excellence and academic commitment. And it's definitely a great privilege for us to have you with us here for this valedictory function. And though it's not a welcome speech, I do welcome you, dear sir, most warmly to our institution.
Thank you. Thank you.
And I also thank all the collaborators. We know today our strength lies in collaboration. Bhagya has already mentioned the name of our collaborators, the Society of Bridges of India and the Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad. They have both been a very vital factor in the success of this venture. I must thank both our collaborators for the support they have extended to us. And I thank everybody who has participated in this venture, be it students or be it research scholars or teaching faculty. We know that participation is a secret to the success of any venture. So whatever we plan or whatever we visualize, it doesn't take off unless we have a group of people who are willing to take part in the event. And we are so happy with the response this event has got. And I thank each and every one, those who participated, those who won awards. I think my heartfelt thanks to all of them. I know sir is very busy today and he's got a meeting coming up, so I will not steal any more of his time. So have a very enriching day, and congratulations to each and everyone who worked for the success of this event. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, dear Dr. Lata. As Ms. Lata has just mentioned, we are indeed privileged to have with us here today Dr. Gabriel Simon Patton, Professor and Head of the Department of Commerce, Director, IQAZ, University of Kerala. Dr. Patel is serving as General Secretary of Indian Accounting Association, which has 50 branches across the country, and he is also the coordinator for the flagship career guidance scheme for school children, My Career, My Dream, an approved research guide of University of Kerala in both commerce and management studies. His areas of interest include banking, rural finance, human resource management, cooperation analysis of financial statements, and working results of business enterprises. With much delight, I welcome you, sir, for the valedictory address.
Thank you. Thank you, and very good afternoon to one and all. Dr. Lata, the principal of St. Joseph's Women's College, Alapra, Dr. Bhagya, Dr. Nimisha, all the other dignitaries and participants across the country. At the outset, I congratulate all of you for this great work that you have done in terms of research, and also for the wide participation that you could command in achieving this deadline of getting into the nitty-gritties of research. Again, I'm happy that you have involved some undergraduate and postgraduate students in this research colloquium of yours. So all the best for your future efforts on research, and I hope you will continue with the same as we go ahead with this. Now, you have all heard a lot about research, and now we are coming to the valedictory function of this entire session of yours. Now, when we normally talk about research, what comes to our mind is it's the biggest degree, it is the tallest degree, then you're going to have DR prefixed to your name, somebody is going to call you by a doctor title. Dr. Lata and all is very fortunate that now you're being called Dr. Lata, Dr. Bhagya. So that is one more thing which is going to happen. Then we come across lots of terms and things like review of literature is going on, statement of the problem is ready, objectives are there. So it's like it goes in that form. But unfortunately, we don't try to understand that research has got something which is quite different and unique, where we need to understand what actually it is. Because when we say research, this is what my exercise have been for a long time. What is often associated with it is the degree. So we are more concerned about the degree. And for that degree, what should be done? So that two important allegations against research today, when it comes to all quality dimensions and quality accreditation agencies. One is that they are saying research is highly ritualistic. That means we are just fulfilling certain rituals and it goes on, and a basic change does not happen. Everybody says new knowledge is created, but right from the beginning, day one, every question is repeatedly asked. What is new? What is new? Yes, you got a degree. As I said, you got the highest degree. You are going to be called a doctor, but what is new? We are struggling to find what exactly is new. So tagged with the word research, there is this new, or there is this creativity, an element of creativity in it. Finding out something new, as simple as that. And for finding out something new, Is it necessary that you should have a master's degree, and should you be registered, and should you do all these things? We are struggling to find what exactly is new. So,
Excuse me, sir. I think you muted the word research.
There is this.
I was muted all through, or right now?
Or there is no, this just now, just creativity, sorry. An element
so,
of creativity.
We had a person who came from New Zealand, and he started talking about how they guide, how teachers guide researchers there. So he was saying that we used to have 50 scholars, 60 scholars guiding 50 people, 60 people. So all in the university, they were looking at what is up. We are saying that a guide should have 8 scholars, 4 scholars. He's talking about 50, 60. So when his presentation went on, down the line, he was talking about the undergraduate students, the postgraduate students, the school students who are guided. So they talk about research, even at the school level. The research is not always associated with, it need not always be associated with academics. And even if it is associated with academics, it need not be always to be associated with something which is post-masters. That is, you do it after your master's degree. It can happen even before. And it is a myth that always you need to have what you call a master's degree, or your, it is not even necessary that you should know how to read and write to do research. To be very frank, I don't know if you have heard about this. Even a person who is illiterate can do research. Now, the difference is a person who has a master's degree is doing research with the theories behind him or her. The other person also does research. You might have heard about the tribal medicine that was developed by a lady from the forest. And you might have heard about how the tribes know how to neutralize venom if a snake bites. This has come out of research. But if you ask them, they might not know the chemical composition of the leaves or the juice that they extract. That they might not know. So the research which they do and an academician does is just this. We know the chemical composition. We know the theories. We know the existing knowledge that has been built so far, and then we are doing research. Whereas the other one, it comes through trial and error, where they try to find out something new. And at times, you see that there is more application even for things which are new, on which they created that even without having a sound base of the theories. Now, just the example of tribes that I gave, if you ask the fishermen who venture into the sea or go into the sea to catch fish, they have their own notions on what it means when the wind moves in this form or the waves move in this form. This is through some studies. If a housewife is trying to cook by using different methodologies in terms of saving fuel, there is some research in that. If a child tries to understand how a flower blossoms in a garden, there is some research in that. So research is, in fact, searching for something new which you need to find out. So it's finding out something new. In my valedictory address, I would just try to talk about these different approaches or dimensions to research, which is very, very important, which has to be very much linked to the basic philosophy of what research is, even for your doctoral program. Be you are a research guide or a research scholar, whatever. Because I'll just give some examples, because that will be, I think, more interesting as far as you are concerned. We have lots of research topics talking about problems and prospects, challenges, such issues. Now, this is just, that's why I said ritualistic. It's just created without understanding what exactly is the problem. Now, I'm from the commerce background, and we have got lots of things which deal with the industry. So here, people just start talking about problems, which the people from the industry, they say, this is not our true problem. Our problem is something else which nobody wants to study. And you're studying some problems which are not problems which we don't want to see. Same happens with many other professions. When you talk with those who are in Bhasha Institute, or when you talk with the professional bodies in sciences and technology, they are having some genuine problems which they would like to resolve, or they would like to address, or on which they would like to find out something new, which remain unaddressed And for your research, you cook up a problem because there a statement of the problem is very important. You write something as a statement of the problem, and people like us, we sit in different committees and we struggle and struggle and struggle and keep asking the scholar, what exactly is the problem? What is the problem that prompted you to take up this particular work? So research is essentially finding out something new. It is a movement from the known to the unknown. I'm giving the second approach. This finding something new comes through a journey from the known to the unknown. That means there are two parts in any research that you talk about. Something which is known and something which you would like to make known. What is known is what you're trying to project in your literature. What is that you would like to make known is that new which you're talking about. Today in every public viva, everywhere people are saying that this is new. They're saying this was said by that person. This was earlier done by that man. This was earlier talked about by somebody else. So what is that what you want to do? And the answer, simple answer is, I don't want to do anything. I just want a degree and that's why I did it. So if you want to get something new, there is a journey from the known to the unknown. Now, sitting in different positions, if you want to find out something new, understand that new knowledge does not come out of vacuum. I'm not just talking about theoretical research. Let it be a new a movie, a new cinema, a new song, a playback song, a new poetry, a new drama, a new play, a new poem. It all comes from something which is existing in some other form. And we are making a journey from there to what we would like to prove. So we get a lot of people say that I want to study motivation. I want to study people's planning. I want to study this philosophy. So the first question that we ask is, who is the first man who talked about it? What is that which is known already in that on that dimension? If you do not know that, how can you find something new? And how do you know it all? It is new. So I must be able to say that this is what has been known so far. And this is, you look at all forms of inventions and discoveries, which are classic examples of good research. Any research you take, invention of the aeroplane, steam engine, electric bulb, or any invention or any discovery, you will see behind that an underlying philosophy of known to the unknown. Just look at the simple, the Wright brothers, when you talk about aeroplane. History is very clearly spelling out that how did they start off? The starting point was how birds fly. Understanding how birds fly, known. Based on how birds fly, they started thinking, if birds can fly like this, can we not create a machine that can fly? So they said, this is something which we do not know, but we would like to find out whether there can be a machine that flies. This was how the invention of an aeroplane took place. Known, unknown. Gap is very, very clear. Then you look at the aeroplane at that time and the aeroplane that you have now. Somebody said, let us enhance the speed, let us reduce the weight, let us create something like jet planes, this, that, all things happened. Same with any invention or discovery. So as a person who's aspiring to find out something new, catch hold of what is known. What is existing? What is that which is currently known to you? And from there, I would like to see something new. So this known is based on the theories that exist and the context in which it existed. Two things. That is where your academic research becomes important. The theories that exist and the context in which, suppose I'm talking about COVID pandemic. There are theories on this virus and the way the mutation takes place or the context in which it applies. So these two things gel over there. And there from there, it, in fact, they take off. So it's a journey from the known to the unknown. That way, let us try to look at research. Let us be very clear. This is what is said by others. This is what has been manifested in terms of outcomes and applications so far. And this is what I would like to establish over a period of time. Again, research is a convergence between theories inside and observations outside. Where I said research is finding out something new, known to the unknown, theories inside and observations outside. So the context for research comes from certain things. You look at the need for energy, what happened with the World War and how the penicillin was invented, the need for antibiotics, the need for new medicine, the need for the vaccination that we are now talking about. It came from certain theories which a person internalized and certain things which were happening outside, the corona pandemic that took place. This virus is doing this damage. It behaves in this form. These are the theories. Now let me link. One man who sat under a tree, he saw an apple falling to the ground, and what happened? A new theory. I'm talking about Newton. Now, what is this? What was that? What was actually happening there? The internalized, well-conceived theories which are inside me finds a blending between something happening outside, falling of the apple. If even before this man sat under the tree, many person like you and me, we also sat under different trees. Only thing is, maybe in Kerala, instead of apple, we might have seen falling mangoes and falling jackfruits and different things. Many things fell, nothing happened. Today, for those who do research, there are falling apples in different situations. Somebody who studies psychology, when they reach home, if they read or see about a case of suicide, it's a falling apple for them. Somebody in the area of health science, if they see COVID pandemic affecting, it's a falling apple for them. Somebody in environment science, the flood which affected your village or your place or the news that has come, it's a falling apple for them. How does the theory relating to this blend or match with something that happens outside? For Newton, he had with him what was called a hypothesis. That means he internalized all the theories associated with bodies being attracted to the earth. And he had a gut feeling that there could be a force which attracts bodies or which attracts things to the earth. But he was not able to prove that. That's what we call a hypothesis. At that moment, he saw the apple that got detached. Just as I said, a suicide case or the natural disaster that is taking place, or in every module that we study, let it be your undergraduate program, your postgraduate, in every module that you study, the innovativeness in teaching and research comes from the fact or the way or the methodology or what we call the pedagogy through which the teacher tells the student that this is the theory. Now you look outside. What makes IISCs and MITs and IITs great institutes? They take up case studies. They take up live examples. They take up observational methods. So you study something, you just relate it to something which happens outside, related to real life cases, related to identification, and it is a blending or a wonderful, what you call, close association between the theory and the practice. So two things are again important here. Just as I said, known to the unknown. The way I internalize the theories, it should not be just for the sake of reproduction. I have internalized it and I'm going to reproduce it at the time of examination. I have internalized it to conceive and understand the concept well. When I have done that well, I don't stop there. I see what associated with my learning. That's why I said a child learns about how a plant comes up, how flowering takes place, or how the fruits come up. Then it is trying to relate it with what happens outside. That's why in our example, we are relating it with what happens in the industry. Somebody who wants to study motivation, you try and look at a context where there is frustration, where there is burnout. Somebody who wants to study about accounting, look at the accounting practices which are happening outside. So when you do that, you will see that there is something new which needs to be unfolded, something new which has to be manifested, something, some new method, some new processes, some new product, some new application, some new services. Certain things can just be a value chain, a small value change in it, but it is your contribution. So you need not change the entire world through your research. Bring in one small change where we are saying that I am use the existing theory in a context, in a context. I used to keep thinking, even when these floods came up, there are several nations, including the United States of America, where in different places, you cannot even construct a new house. It is an outcome from research because of several reasons, say on the bank of a river or in certain places where the density of population is at certain levels, you're not allowed to do certain things. Now, if you're making a discrete allowance for all these things, where does your theory and environment science, where does your the climate change gel with something which is happening outside? It is up to researchers, the undergraduates, the postgraduates, to open their mind and say that this is what the theory says, this is the context in which I live, this is how it should be looked into in future. That is research. So the third approach is actually conceiving theories, looking at observations that happen outside. Now, research is basically something which is very closely associated to a clinical diagnostic process. Again, for your easy understanding, it is having two parts in it. Just suppose I have a headache or I have a stomachache, whatever, a medical issue. I try to resolve that with my own, my knowledge or my information that I have. Say if my head is aching, I believe that, okay, it could be because I'm tired, so let me take rest. So problem, headache, and I'm trying to resolve it, a decision. I took rest, but my head is still aching. Now what do? I decide, okay, let me take a tablet. I take a paracetamol or whatever, but my head is still aching. Now I decide that I'm not able to resolve my problem. So what do? I go and consult a medical practitioner. Now, what this medical practitioner does is actually research. The medical practitioner, you go and tell him that your head is aching. He is asking you some questions at the beginning. Or in other words, he is identifying the problem. What has caused your headache? Because a headache could occur because of n number of reasons. It could be because of strain, it could be because of some neuro problem, it could be because of tumor, whatever. It could have different forms of headache, will have different causes. So he's trying to identify. Now, once he has identified, then he has to prescribe the medicine, the process. He might say that this might require 1 week's medicine, this, that, or it might require a surgery, or it might require certain observational methods, so on and so forth. So research essentially has two things. One is knowing the problem, and second is the methodology to arrive at a resolution. That resolution can be new knowledge. You might not be solving it, but you might be at least giving the information on how it can be mitigated or perhaps solved. So it has got two problems. Now, my question is, where do you see more significance or more importance? Definitely both are important. Identifying the problem and giving the medicine. Both are important. But relatively, in terms of new knowledge, where will we attach more importance? Is it to the problem or giving the medicine? Even if you give the wrong medicine, the patient might die. But simple wisdom will tell you that what is more important is identifying or the right diagnosis. Knowing why your head is aching. This is the prime responsibility of every researcher. I have with me a very definite, a very focused, a very clearly spelled out problem. And I'm with that problem in as the core, I try to identify a process to resolve it. But let me tell you, very unfortunately, today, most of our interventions generally are on the second part. That means, I don't know whether you have had those sessions in your 10-day colloquium. We talk about how to review your literature. I'm not saying it's unimportant, just like giving medicine, it is important. You talk how to analyze the data. You give them different workshops on different statistical tools. But the basic issue is they do not have with them a genuine, real research problem. So if you do not know what exactly is the problem, then your subsequent steps towards addressing the problem does not get solved. That means you have with you a problem which is not true, then most of your processes might not be true. How to select the sample, how to get the, what literature backing is there into it. So identifying what exactly is the research issue. And generally, if you don't have a research, see, that's why I said when applied research, the tribes who were living in the forest, they were encountering a true problem. Snakes are biting. And they went in search of, they were not sure whether they're going to get a degree for this or whether this is going to be scientifically established. They just wanted to have a solution. I'm not saying that you don't go by the other things. The part two of it is very important and you need to run by it. But try to see that an identified research issue, and there are lots and lots of that in and around you. If you look at what is being reported, and your reach towards that is phenomenally high today, because on your fingertips, you know anything that is happening in any part of the world. All research issues. Suppose you're talking about the floods which happened in Kerala the last couple of days. Similar floods that have happened across the globe and similar conditions today are easily accessible to anybody. So the means, technology has made all this possible. The means through which you reach out with your research issues have become very easy. Data is on your fingertips. You want data on animal life, plant life, flora, fauna. You want your data on total exports, imports, economy, GDP, industry, literature, the different forms of art, culture, everything is available. But I need to understand what actually is researchable. What actually is the issue on which we need to transform? The issue on which we need to actually create new knowledge. That is actually, a hypothesis is very simple. We need not go by any technical jargon in terms of research. Hypothesis is just hypothesis. Hypo means less than, thesis means something which is what you call established and in that form. So empirically tested and established. So it's something below that. And how does something below that come? That's where I started with. When I know what is known. The same example, man sitting under the tree. When he got into the intricacies of the theories which are known, when he understood the facts which are currently known, then he started pondering. He started having a feeling that this is because of this. My theories in psychology, or my theories in sociology, or my theories in family life, when I have learned that, when I have understood that, when I have used that properly, internalized that properly, then I see a suicide case, I try to relate this with those theories, and I have a feeling that this is happening because of this. If I am in biotechnology, or if maybe in biosciences, and I see lifestyle diseases across, I try to relate these theories with the eating habits or the food habits of people around, and I have an inclined feeling that this could be because of this. So, hypothesis. That's all. Let us forget about the technical terms and all that. It's a tentative kind of a feel that we have that something is occurring or something is happening because of this. And that happens when the theories are strongly ignited, or those theories burn inside me. So that's why I said it comes from your school days. You talk about a plant, or you talk about a character in a play, or you talk about culture, or you talk about human life, or you talk about a cell. It must provoke thinking in terms of what actually happens in the real life world. It must make you think in terms of what is actually happening in the real life world. And that thinking, or that inspiration that you draw, will make you ponder deeper. That is simply research, that's all. In one dimension, I'm moving in terms of something that I have understood very well. That is how even the medical practitioner actually links his theories. That's why they ask. This is something which is very common. That's why I'm saying research is not very complex and something your biggest degree and all that. It is very down to earth kind of a thing. What does this medical practitioner ask when you say my head is aching? He'll say, when did it start? Was it before food or after food? Did you expose yourself to sunlight? He's asking some questions. And generally these questions are based on the theories that they have learned. If it is before food, maybe it is because of indigestion. If it is because of this, it may be because of migraine. So they are trying to link the problem that is there before them or the patient that has come before them to the associated theories that they have learned. This is exactly what all of us are doing. But the problem, yeah, the issue with us is we are taking it just as a ritual. That's what Dr. Lata was earlier referring to. That means I need to get a degree. First is you give your synopsis, then you have to face the first DC. First DC is over, then immediately the candidate will say, oh, one step is over. And for that, what is required? I need to have statement of the problem. I need to have objectives. Then you say, how many objectives? Two or three? You'll be having one or you might be having two, but you'll make it three, four, according to what others are doing. One is to ascertain, then the next one is to find out, the third one is to determine, all will mean the same. So these are things which are happening. Then you will say methodology, they'll ask me one question, what is a population, what is a sample? So you'll write some population, some sample, whether it is necessary or not, we do not know. So you go by that and then you start your work and you will say that there will be something like a coursework. All these things are very purposive. Now when I'm saying it is a movement from the known to the unknown, your coursework is a deliberate effort to see that you have internalized the known. If you have not done that, you cannot move to the unknown. But then again, coursework is again another ritual. Why are we using the word ritual? We are using the word ritual because ritual is more used in religion. We are ritualistic. I should go to the temple, I should go to the church, or I should go to the mosque, and I should finish certain things. And I'm happy because I have done all that. But is it actually changing me? Is it actually transforming me? The number of people who go to Shabrimala, the number of people who go to Velangani, the number of people who go to Mecca, it's all on the rise. If you look at faithfulness or if you look at being religious, it is something like 99.99%. But along with that, you see crimes are also happening. So I'm not able to distinguish between or draw a line between the two. I'll go to church, I'll pray, and I'll lie, and I'll pray, and I'll lie, and I'll pray. It all goes together. I'm corrupt, and I pray, and I'm corrupt, and I pray. So I'm just happy that that ritual is going on. Every year it is going on, every Sunday it's happening, every day I do certain things, and I just go on. I don't relate the same. So this is where we are talking about. I have to see that the small things that I do find meaning in terms of new knowledge, however small it is. What about your research? Research can happen in your undergraduate programs, a small project. Research can happen even in an assignment that you do. Research can happen even in the way a student identify a problem and make a presentation in a seminar. So this mindset is very important. This approach is very important. That means with the theories, with the underlying facts, with the underlying observations, with the underlying data that is existing, how I try and create something new, which can be contextualized. It may be something which is applicable only with Alappuzha. It may be something which is applicable only with one family, or it may be something which is applicable in one society, or it may be even in one small individual. But dare I say something new? Dare I say something unique? Dare I say something different? This is actually what we need to have with us. So you see, there'll be a lot of opportunities for consultancy. The funding that you get for new knowledge today is so tremendous and high. We could not even have ever thought about it maybe 15, 20 years back. There is lots and lots of demand for new ideas, new thinking, creative ways of doing things. And the basics come from the current information and knowledge which is existing. That is acting as an agent, as a catalyst to transform into something new. So everything new created provide some space for betterment, provide some scope for further improvement, further change. That is what we are actually looking for. So when you are holding such kind of sessions, yes, you do all your theoretical kind of looking into all the theories of how to have a good research report, how to have a good review of literature, how to have good analysis of data. It's all well and good. But along with that, try to, what you call, inject this philosophy of how precisely we need to understand that something is there already. I know that well. I would like to find out something new because there is a problem there and I'm going to address that problem. As simple as that. Research is just addressing two questions. Number one, what is that you wanted to find out? Be very clear about it. What is that you wanted to find out? Number two, how is that you found it out? That's all. What is that you wanted to find out is the problem. How is that you found it out is the methodology. So this can happen in a case study. This can happen in any of these processes that goes into it. And that is where we try to get generate new knowledge. At the highest level, it happens with your doctoral program or your postdoctoral program. It can happen with a new product. It can happen with a new service. It can happen with a new application. On all these dimensions, we are having lots and lots of opportunities. For a researcher, sky is the level up to which they can grow. But we often see it as the means to get into a college or a means to get a promotion. Because UGC says for a promotion, you need to have a PhD degree. So I have a PhD degree. Then UGC said for a promotion, you must become a guide. Then now I'm a guide. Then they said to become a professor, you must produce one PhD. So now I have produced one PhD. You're all going by that minimum kind of that. Now, see, whenever we started talking about the quality of research going down after having making all these mandatory things important, 35 years, 25 years back, even 30 years back, when we were doing research, there was nothing like any incentive for getting into college. There was no advance increments. There was no quality interventions like you have today. Today, for you need to have your NET examination. You need to have coursework. You need to have publication. You need to have plagiarism check. You need to have your pre-submission. And after doing all these things, you're saying quality is lost. Earlier, these things were not there. So what has happened is, in spite of all the interventions that you're talking about, unless the inner urge for change does not come, it is not likely to sink into you. So my humble request is, as a takeaway, what we need to look at, you have been looking at, you have had 120 people presenting papers and all. Let us try to see how we need to learn about research. We need to understand research as an element which gives something new, which is a movement from the known to the unknown, where I'm very clear on what is known and what is that which is unknown, which I would like to make known. And how actually I'm linking the theories which have been deeply ingrained into me with the realities that is happening outside. And that itself is the novelty of what I would like to highlight. Thank you so much for this opportunity. I wish you all the very, very best in your research pursuits. And hopefully, maybe as Dr. Lata said, sometime, because I think this is one of the colleges which I have not personally visited. In Alappuzha, almost all other colleges, sometime or the other, I have been there. So sometime maybe in future, we can have more of interaction on this. Across the country, we keep interacting on many of these issues. I would like to see some good papers coming out on learning to do research, research as a mindset, as a philosophy. If you take research as something which is a continuing way of looking at your learning, then for every teacher, there are lots and lots of unfolding opportunities, specifically in the new world when we are talking about all forms of research outcomes, when we are talking about consultancy, when we are talking about startups, when we are talking about blended learning. All these gives a lot of inputs for your learning in future. So I hope you will carry forward some of these thoughts on which I have sown the seeds for you to think over. Thank you so much and wish you all the very best. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, dear sir. You actually gave us enough food for thought actually. And the entire view about research we all had, you have changed that within the last 20, 25 minutes of your deliberation. Actually, it was really inspiring, and I'm sure research aspirants, they have inspired from your words of wisdom. And, you know, the way you have explained research, everything you define in binary terms, the known, the unknown, how to internalize theory and put that into practice. And it was really inspiring. And I think you are a person whom you can actually listen for long hours. Really looking forward to meet you in person.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much. Because I have another program, I would like to leave. So if you don't mind, allow me to leave. And again, we'll meet sometime again later. Thank you so much.
Sure, sir. Thank you so much.
Sir, you must visit.
Yeah.
Okay. I think sir has left.
Yes. So that was a very inspiring, well-lit address by Dr. Simon Thettle. Now we move on to the much awaited moment of our program. As I said in the beginning, we had more than 120 presentations across nation under 9 different categories. And this year's ResearchCast theme was Research and Development for Nation Building. And paper presentations were evaluated on the basis of novelty, methodology, justification, and presentation skills. And before we announce the winners, a word to the participants. Dears, you're all here because of your hard work and determination. And remember, winning is not everything, but the effort or the winning to win is what matters. So whether you win or lose, it shouldn't affect you, as great challenges are there for you to embrace. So wishing you all the best, I invite Dr. Srikala, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, to announce the winner of Excelsior Award of ResearchCast 2021. Over to you, Srikala.
Okay, so am I audible?
Yes, yes, please.
Okay. I think I need permission to share my screen. Administrator?
Hello, Akhil. Hello. Yes.
Srikala.
Hello, Srikala. Hello.
Yes.
I think you can share.
Good afternoon, one and all. As we know, prize distribution is a memorable, proud, special, and most awaited event for every competition. It gives a sense of responsibility for fulfilling new commitments with dedication. All the prize winners are a source of motivation for others. Congratulations to all in advance. We conducted competitions in 9 disciplines and in 4 categories. Let us look at the results in category-wise in subject. For zoology, the competition was held on 6th October, and the resource person was Dr. E.B. Radhakrishnan, retired principal scientist and head CMFRI Kochi. The category of research scholars, first prize goes to Vinod S., Department of Biotechnology, CUSAT. Second prize goes to Amrita Panja, Benares Hindu University, Varanasi. Third prize goes to Praveena KK, PG and Research Department of Zoology, Farooq College, Calicut. The category of post-graduation, the first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Ramsheena Sampi Institute of Advanced Study, Malappuram. Second prize goes to Simna Siddiq, Government College for Women, Vadudakkad. Third prize is shared by two participants. One is Sri Lakshmi P. Marathanisius College, Kodamangalam. And another one is Praveena Dev, SN College, SN Puram, Alappuzha. The category undergraduation, first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Alina Dennis, St. Xavier's College for Women, Alua. Second prize goes to Pavitra Prasad, CMS College, Kottayam, Kerala. Third prize goes to Aisha N, St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha. Congratulations to the winners. For botany, the competition was held on October 6th and 7th, where the chief guest was Dr. Anju Tia, Secretary SBTI, and the resource person was Dr. Nigel George, Joint Treasurer SBTI. In the category of faculty, first prize goes to Dr. Lubaina A.S., PG and Research Department of Botany, Christian College, Katakada. Second prize goes to Trisho Mariam Paul, Center for Drug Discovery and Development, Satipama Institute of Science and Technology, Chennai. Third prize goes to Dr. Anisri V. Nair, Marine Biotechnology Division, ICAR. In the category of research scholars, first prize goes to Dr. Lailaja VP, ICAR, Kochi. Second position goes to Monica L. Jadhav, Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry, Siusha College of Pharmacy, Mumbai. Third position goes to Nisarga D. Saman, Siusha College of Pharmacy, Mumbai. The category post-graduation, first prize goes to Puneet Somagowda, Department of Plant Biotechnology, Maharashtra. Second position goes to Blue Lia, Department of Botany, St. Albert's College, Ernakulam. Third position goes to Lakshmi Raj, Department of Botany, Sanadana Dharma College, Alappuzha. Under UG category, first prize goes to Anupa K. Babu, Department of Botany, Newman College, Thodupuzha. Second position goes to Jasina T., Department of Microbiology, ST College, Alappuzha. Third position goes to Lina Varghese, Department of Botany, St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha. Congratulations to the winners. For physics, the competition was held on 7th October. The plenary talk was delivered by Dr. Smijesh N., Assistant Professor, School of Pure and Applied Physics, Mahatma Gandhi University. We have one more subject expert, Dr. Deebu Thomas, Assistant Professor, Nirmalagiri College, Kootuparamba. For post-graduation, first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Rahul P.A., Department of Physics, SN College, Sirathala. The second prize is shared by two candidates. First one is Puku Thomas from Vesalius College, Kottayam. Second one is Anju S. from St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha. Third prize goes to Vineet K.K., Kuriakos Gregorius College, Pambadi, Kottayam. For the section undergraduates, first prize goes to Christopher Thomas, Department of Physics, St. Stephen's College, Ullavur. Second prize goes to Fahma Munir and her team of St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha. Third prize is shared by Akhil K.M. and his team of St. Stephen's College, Ullavur, and Anila S. of St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha. Congratulations. For chemistry, the competition was held on October 7th. And the plenary talk was delivered by Dr. Prema K.H., Associate Professor, Department of Chemistry, SB College, Alappuzha. In the category of research scholars, first position and Excelsior Award goes to Venkatesh Krishna M, Department of Chemistry, Bharathiyar University. In the category of undergraduates, first position and Excelsior Award goes to Shilpa AS, Department of Chemistry, Mother Teresa College, Nellikkad. Second position goes to Anjana Anil RA, Department of Chemistry, All Saints College, Thiruvananthapuram. Third position goes to Asha Emma, Department of Chemistry, Srinarayana College for Women, Kollam. Congratulations to the winners. For mathematics, the competition was held on October 8th and the resource person was Dr. K.S. Peenath, Professor in Mathematics, School of Distance Education, University of Kerala. The category of faculty, first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Adul T.B., Department of Mathematics, S.N. College, Punalur. Second prize goes to Timmy Tomi, Department of Mathematics, St. George's College, Arivikkuram. For post-graduation, the Excelsior Award goes to Neetu Mariam Sebastian, Department of Mathematics, SD College, Alappuzha. Second prize goes to Adulya M. Anil, Department of Mathematics, St. George's College, Arivikkuram. For undergraduates, the Excelsior Award goes to Alina Joseph, Department of Mathematics, St. Stephen's College, Udaipur. And there is one more consolation prize for Ms. Alshima, Department of Mathematics, TKM College, Kollam. Congratulations to the winners. Was Pradesh P, Assistant Professor in History, St. Michael's College, Chertala. For faculty, the first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Ajay T. Joseph, Guest Lecturer in History, St. Thomas College, Palay. Second prize goes to Abarna M. Nath, Guest Lecturer, St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha. Third prize goes to Arya Udayakumar, Guest Lecturer of Economics, St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha. Under the category of Research Scholars, first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Suraj Rajan K, Trip Fellow, Jindal School of International Affairs, New Delhi. Second prize goes to Shiraz Shanawas, School of International Relations and Politics, MG University. Third prize goes to Anjana Menon, Research Scholar in History, Maharaja's College, there are two consolation prizes. And is Deviga MS, University of Kerala, Karyavattam Campus, Trivandrum. Next is Arya S. Chandi, PG Diploma in Rural Management, IGNO Regional Center, Ernakulam. For the category of undergraduates, first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Harikrishnan AM and his team of SD College, Alappuzha. Second prize goes to Sandra PM and her team of St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha. Third prize goes to Anika S. Menon and her team, Mar Ivanius College, Trivandrum. For home science, the competition was held on 9th October and the plenary talk was Deshmi H. Pujara, Assistant Professor, Department of Home Science, St. Teresa's College, Ernakulam. And there are two subject experts, Dr. Hemangini Gandhi and Dr. Krishnaja U. Under the category of Research Scholars, the first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Vinita Antony, Department of Food Service Management and Dietetics, Coimbatore. Second prize goes to Urmila Vijayan P, Department of Home Science, Vimala College, Thrissur. The third prize is shared by Srija S of Department of Home Science, St. Teresa's College, Ernakulam, and Divya M, PG Department of Home Science, Government College for Women, Thiruvananthapuram. For post graduation, first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Inderdeep Kaur Verma, Department of Foods and Nutrition. Second prize goes to Ashla Joseph, Department of Home Science, St. Teresa's College, Ernakulam. Third prize goes to Elizabeth Varghese, Department of Home Science and Center for Research, St. Teresa's College, Ernakulam. For undergraduates, first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Jasmine and her team of Department of Home Science, Vimala College, Thrissur. Second prize goes to Anu Mariam John, Department of Home Science and Center for Research, St. Teresa's College. And third prize goes to Fahuma Mansoor and her team of St. Joseph's College for Women, Alappuzha. For commerce, the competition was held on October 9th. And the chief guest was Dr. S. Santosh Kumar, Professor, School of Management Studies, Gujarat. Under the category of faculty, the first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Anu P. Matthew, Devamada College, Koravelangad. Under the category of research scholars, the first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Akhil Menon, Institute of Management in Government, Trivandrum. Second prize goes to Vishuja V., Institute of Management in Government, Trivandrum. Third prize is shared by Shia IS and Vijay BS of Institute of Management in Government, Trivandrum. Under the category of postgraduates, first prize and Excelsior Award goes to Ginu Maria Varghese of St. Stephen's College, Udavur. Second prize goes to Jobin Chos of Devamada College, Koravelangad. For undergraduates, there is a consolation prize for Sajilal of UIT Arur. Congratulations to the winners. For literature, the competition was held on October 6th and the research person was Anjita Krishna. There is one consolation prize for post-graduation. It is for Daya Mukesh. Once again, congratulations to all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Srikala, and congratulations to the winners. Now it's time for us to listen to some of the feedback of the participants. So I request the participants of Reserka to share their experience. Hello.
Good evening.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, I'm Anjana. I'm a PhD research scholar in the Department of History, Maharajas College. It is very rare that any institute conducts a research paper presentation or competition for all the subjects alike. And in such cases, they usually concentrate on a particular subject. So in that, for giving such an opportunity, we would like to thank all the members of the college and coordinators. It was a very much great opportunity for almost all the departments. Also, I would like to give a small suggestion. Just like we have different paper presentations for chemistry, physics, biology, and all the science subjects, social science and the methodology doesn't come under a single framework. In the next competition, it will be very much great if political science, history, and other subjects are not considered as an allied subject because the methodology is very much different. So competing in the same perspective doesn't seem great. So that's my small suggestion. Once again, thank you for the great opportunity.
Thank you, Anjana, for the valuable feedback. And we'll take your suggestion again for next year's Reserka for sure. Thank you so much. Any other participants?
Good evening.
Yeah, thank you.
Good evening, ma'am. My name is Urmila. I'm faculty of Vimala College, Thrissur. I wholeheartedly thank you for the Reserka team for giving me an opportunity to participate in the same. I thank you, Dr. Rita, ma'am, for wonderful organization. Thank you, Dr. Bhagya, and the whole team of Reserka. Also, the bandage session was wonderful, especially Dr. Simon Thattil's message of simple message of finding something new in the perspective of research. It was brilliant. Thank you all for the opportunity.
Thank you so much. Anyone else interested in giving your valuable feedback?
Okay, it was a grant. It provided a chance to hear talk from very eminent personalities like Dr. Gabriel sir, Dr. Edithil Vijayan sir, Dr. Rishmi ma'am, and Rita ma'am. Okay, so I'm taking this opportunity to congratulate all the hands behind this program. Especially, I had to say the name of Dr. Phagia, which was constantly contacting us and giving timely updates regarding the presentations and all. So definitely, this program enlightened and enriched our thoughts and our views on research. So thank you for the entire team, especially the members of research committee, St. Joseph College, St. Joseph College for Women, Alappuzha, and the members of Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad, and members of Biotechnologist Society of Biotechnologists of India. Okay, thank you. Thanks a lot for giving this opportunity.
Thank you, dears, for your feedback. We'll take your suggestions next time and we'll have a more grand Rizurka next year. Now let's move on to the final part of our program. And I invite ADIA Dynamic IQAZ Coordinator, Dr. Anju M. Neelira, to speak a few words.
Thank you, Nimisha. Respected Principal, Dr. Rita Lata Dikoto, guest speaker of the day, Dr. Simon Thattil, Research Coordinator, Dr. Bhagya, research committee members, other dignitaries, faculty members, research scholars, participants, and my dear students. Today, we have come to the final session of this year's Rizurka program. Research committee of St. Joseph's College initiated Rizurka as an ongoing program to strengthen research culture among students, especially the UG and PG students, by providing a platform to share their research ideas. Till late, we know that research was always considered as something to be taken up for the pursuit of PhD degree, and that too in university departments. But the benefits of research to UG and PG students could not be overlooked. The scientific community places increasing importance on research performed at undergraduate and postgraduate levels. The research process has a favorable impact on valuable learning objectives. It also benefits students in having tolerance to obstacles, learning to work independently, understanding how knowledge is constructed, building self-confidence, and many more. The Government of India has launched a string of initiatives to boost research in higher education. Statistics show that we are way behind other countries in the average number of researchers and research publications. For example, while China produces nearly 5 lakh research publications annually, the number in India is just below 1.5 lakhs. The low citation index or the impact factor implies that the quality of the papers are not on par with international standards. It has long been pointed out the problem of students reproducing textbooks in examinations without applying critical thinking, and such culture is carried all the way to higher education. So it is very essential that students be inducted in the culture of research as early as pedagogically possible. This will arouse the interest of students in the subject, and the students might become more inclined to take up research intensive academic programs in future. The research committee of this institution has taken up this challenge, and this is the second successful year of Researcha. Today, we had a very enthusiastic and scholarly person to deliver the valedictory address of this year's Researcha. Dr. Simon has been a mentor to all affiliated institutions over the years. Sir, it has been great listening to you. I would like to congratulate all the participants in the Researcha program who presented their research ideas. Special congratulations to the winners also. I hope Researcha, conducted every year, will be a great opportunity for the students to share their ideas, and wish that this becomes a prestigious platform among researchers in future. Appreciating all the efforts put in by the research committee of the college and the support rendered by Shastra Sahitya Parishad and Society of Biotechnologists, I wish all success to Researcha in the coming years too. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Anju. Now that the valedictory ceremony of Researcha 2021 comes to a happy closure, and I invite Dr. Pingi Cherian, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, to propose a word of thanks.
Thank you, Nimisha Miss. Now we are moving with word of thanks. Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Okay. Acknowledging the good that you are already have in your life is the foundation for all abundance. The best and beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt by heart. Thank you is one such prayer among them. I consider it as a great privilege to give a vote of thanks to all the dignitaries and delegates who have witnessed Researcha 2021. Research and Development for National Building as a memorable and successful event, promoting research and innovation for young minds and fostering research culture among students. I would like to thank our beloved manager, Reverend Dr. Sister Annie Matthew, for the presence of wisdom that radiated a source of energy within us. We will ever remain grateful to you, and we thank Sister for being with us. I also express my heartfelt gratitude to our respected principal, Dr. Rita Ladar Dikoto, for being the catalyst that stimulated us to our best and standing as a pillar of strength. Thank you, ma'am. On the behalf of Research Committee of St. Joseph College for Women, Alappuzha, I would like to thank our chief guest, Dr. G. Gopakumar, former Vice Chancellor, Kerala University, who has graced us with his thought-provoking address in his message. And I'm sure our students are benefited and motivated towards research. I remember with gratitude all the persons who accompanied with us in the research journey, especially Professor Dr. Edathil Vijayan, SBT, I President, for giving us thought-provoking felicitation during inaugural section of our event Researcha 2021. I would like to thank, in behalf of Research Committee, Dr. Gabriel Simon Tattil, Professor and Head, Department of Commerce, University of Kerala, for delivering valuable ideas on creating a change during research, a prominent change in the valedictory function of Researcha 2021. I am much indebted to Dr. T. Pradeep, Chairman, Alappuzha District Subcommittee for Education, Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad, for his general advice and support. Next, we are grateful to our PTA President, Mr. Raju Pralliparambil, for being with us in all our events and give valuable advices for enriching the section. Thank you, sir. Deep felt gratitude to our collaborators, Society of Biotechnologists India and Kerala Shastra Sahitya Parishad. I am thankful to Dr. Anju M. Nerira for our our IQAC coordinator, for motivating and encouraging us for this venture. Special thanks to Dr. Bhagyadi, Research Committee Coordinator, for organizing and executing the platform for the young budding minds to explore their talent. Thank you, Bhagya Miss. In behalf of Research Committee, I extend my gratitude to Dr. Srigalaji for taking efforts and pain while consolidating and announcing the result of Research 2021. Thank you, Srigala. My thanks also goes to my colleagues who have spared their precious time in organizing this program, in particular, the untiring efforts of all. I would like to acknowledge the coordinators representing each department, Dr. Sulina V.S., Head Department of Commerce, Ms. Anjali George, and Ms. Nimisha Francis, Assistant Professor, Department of English, Ms. Sandhya A.K., Ms. Meenu Teresa Joseph, Department of History, Ms. Rimya Deans, Department of Zoology, and Dr. Archana Das, Assistant Professor, Department of Zoology, Dr. Diana K.J. and Dr. Pinky Charyan, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, Dr. Kumari Nisha S., Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, Dr. Bhagya D., Ms. Akshara S., Assistant Professor, Department of Home Science, Dr. Sister Maurice Marley, Dr. Srigalaji, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Dr. Binida Benny, Ms. Chitra K.S., Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, and also Ms. Namida Sara Matthew, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, for their untiring efforts. I'm short of words to their dedication, involvement, and their willingness to take part on the completion of the task beyond this comfort zone. We have been fortunate enough to be backed by a team of very proactive and dedicated staff of our Josephine family. I thank head of the departments, faculty members for being with us and making this event fruitful. Thank you all. I am immensely thankful to Ms. Nimisha Francis, Assistant Professor, Department of English, for her effort towards anchoring of today's program. Thank you, Ms. And also my sincere thanks to Ms. Anjali George, Assistant Professor, Department of English, for her motivation and support in anchoring during inauguration of Research 2021. I would also thank the people who work behind the screen to make this event happen, Mr. Agil and Akshara as technical staff, and our student coordinators for their constant and sincere help in promoting publicity. I am much indebted and thankful to our subject expert and National Advisory Committee members, Dr. Prema H., Associate Professor, Department of Chemistry, SD College, Alappuzha, Kerala. Dr. Anjida Krishna, Assistant Professor, Department of English, Deemed to be University, Bangalore. Dr. E.V. Radhakrishnan, Retired Principal Scientist and Head, ICR Emeritus Scientist, Crustacean Fisheries Division, CMFRA, Kochi. Dr. Smitesh N., Assistant Professor, School of Pure and Applied Physics, Mahatma Gandhi University, Kottayam. Dr. Deepu Thomas, Assistant Professor, Narmagani College. Dr. Reshmi H. Pujara, Assistant Professor, Department of Home Science, St. Joseph's College, Ernakulam. Dr. Himangini Gandhi, Assistant Professor, Department of Food and Nutrition, MS University of Baroda, Vadodara. Dr. Krishnana U., Assistant Professor, Department of Community Science, College of Agriculture, Vellayani. Dr. Anju T.R., Assistant Professor, Department of Biotechnology, Newman College, and Dr. Nigel George, Department of Biotechnology, St. Joseph College, Irinjalapura. Dr. Sandush Kumar, Professor, Department of Commerce, School of Management, CUSAT, Kerala. Dr. Sinath K.S., Professor, Retired, School of Distance Education, University of Kerala. Mr. Pratish P., Assistant Professor, Department of History, St. Michael's College, Chertala. For their perseverance and timely evaluation, suggestions, and feedback, we feel proud and grateful for making us feel happy with your presence. Last but not the least, I thank all the students and their supervising guides for their showing their interest in this program and giving us immediate feedback. The participants were very enthusiastic. I am grateful to all the participants for joining ResearchCar 2021. Wish you all the best. Thank you for being with us in this journey of ResearchCar 2021. I'm sure that the participants must have benefited by attending this multidisciplinary project presentation competition. I once again thank you to contribution that has been made in ResearchCar 2021, a successful event. Expecting your presence in all of our future endeavors. See you all from Josephine family. All stay safe and healthy. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Pinky. The illiterate of 21st century won't be those who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. So as Dr. Tuttle has said, let's learn, unlearn, and relearn. Now the program ResearchCar 2021 has come to an end, and I hope ResearchCar has been an enriching experience for each one of you, and I'm sure that this will be a milestone in your career. Once again, congratulations to all the winners of ResearchCar 2021, and thank you all so much for your participation. And wish to see you all very soon. Thank you. And once again, congratulations to the entire team of research committee, especially Dr. Bhagya, Dr. Srikala, Dr. Pinky, and the head of the captain. Our dear principal, Dr. Rita Lavadikuru, our dynamic IQAZ coordinator, Dr. Anju M. Miliera. Thank you all so much for making our college so proud with this program. Thank you.
Thank you, Nimisha. Thank you so much for beautifully anchoring the program. Thank you so much. Actually, we are grateful. Research committee members are grateful to all the teachers and all the participants for making this program a success. So I think next year also we can proceed with this program with another beautiful new innovative step, I think. Something new we can
do. Kati, congratulations to all. And let us make next year even more of a success and even more innovative. Thank you, Nimisha, for beautiful anchoring. And entire team. I think I saw a request to switch on the video.
Yes, miss.
So that we can take. Can we do that now? Because it's time to leave.
Anju, miss.
I request all the participants to turn on their videos so that we can take a very a small screenshot of our presence virtually here. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you,
sister.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Bhagya, for this opportunity. Thank you all.
Thank you, Bhagya. Thank you. Thank you.